What's good, y'all? It's Abwon, and this is another episode of Face2Face. I am here with the hottest comedian on the East Coast, Monique Latise.
Hey.
So you wanted to talk to him real quick before we jump into this little conversation?
I just want to say hi and thank you to everyone that supports the brand, Monique Latise. I've been doing this for 9 years, and I am just so thankful. It's not an easy job. Comedy is not easy. Comedy is not easy, but I'm grateful that God called me to this business.
Word,
I'm thankful.
Word. We actually at the venue for her latest show at Edge Lounge in Passaic. You killed it. She was hosting. All the headliners was dope. You were dope. It was fantastic.
Everybody.
Fantastic. And she got us in VIP too. So that's
yes.
Tough. So shout out to you. Oh, you're also the first female comedian I've ever had on my station, channel, show, period.
What?
Yeah, so shout out to you. Shout out to you.
All right.
Word. Shout
the female that's coming up.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Oh, yes. You already know. What made you want to get into comedy?
I was depressed.
Okay.
I was very depressed. And I felt like I didn't have a purpose. I was like struggling to find out why God created me. And I went through that for years. Just wondering why he created. I wasn't happy in my relationship, motherhood, as a daughter, and life. I was missing something. So when I connected with comedy, it clicked.
Yeah.
That's why God called me.
You're a natural too. I met her at the Baru Lounge in Newark, and when she was headlining, I was up there minding my business, smoking my little hookah, and she looked
at
me.
It was my birthday last year that I headlined on my birthday.
A year ago.
It was a year ago. Yes.
So it is. It's fate. There you go. Yeah. So I mean, we linked up. I saw at the end of the show. I said I definitely want to interview you, and she actually got on me too. That's why I don't sit in the front row at
comedy
shows anymore. She looked at me. She's like, I know you got good dental insurance because you got some nice teeth. And everybody was looking at me like, oh. I was just like, you know what? After that, I said I'm not sitting in the front row anymore, yo. So. Comedians, man, they're like a hot topic right now. We all know what's going on with the whole Steve Harvey, Monique beef
right.
Going on, Lee Daniels, Cat Williams is beefing with Tiffany Haddish.
Everybody beefing.
Yeah, like what's going on?
I come in peace.
There you go.
I ain't beefing with nobody. I just want to get this money.
There you go.
That's it.
Like I'm looking at it now, like comedians are almost like the new rappers. Like
right.
I've heard stories about comedians stealing other comedians' jokes.
Oh,
they like fighting
yes.
Each other at the end of the shows. Have you ever had any like issues like that?
You know what? Thank God. I do all relatable materials to my life. All of my jokes is about my life. So if you hear something that's relatable to you, you must went through the same thing. So that's the only kind of jokes I'm telling. I don't want to steal nobody's jokes. Because you know what? Like big girls, if we all talk about the same thing, you may be like, she's still a whole fine joke. But
you
should be 100 pounds, ma. We all got that big girl joke. Don't mean I'm stealing it, but you know, we like to, I'm not really a fan of people who be like, oh, my joke was stolen. Throw your creative twist in it and nobody can steal your jokes.
I remember you was talking to us before we started about how people don't think clean comedy is funny comedy. You want to talk about that?
I'm glad you brought that up. A lot of people think that, you know, when they hear that I do gospel and secular, they be like, you not really that funny then.
Mm.
Let me tell you something. I keep that energy consistent. So whether you see me in secular in the hood or you see me at a gospel show, it's the same energy, same jokes.
Yup. She be out here, she'll roast you, yo. She be out here, but she's funny, though. She's funny.
I roast you.
You'll be roasting people, yo. You be going at them, but
not
in a disrespectful way. Like, not when they want to walk out like, nah, she's
right.
Proud.
Like, you do got pretty
funny.
Teeth, though.
Thank you. I try to brush them every day. You were on the Apollo.
Woo!
I saw that. I was on the gram. I was like, yo, she's doing her thing. She's doing
came
her thing.
Came in third place the first time, and I got booed the second time.
Wait. All right, so the first time, so you made it to third place, and then they invited you back?
Well, I made it to the next round.
Okay.
So the next round is when I got booed. Boo! It was crazy.
What? How far into the set?
As soon as, I would say like a minute on stage.
Were you the only comedian?
Yeah. Comedy ain't no joke.
I know. That's why I'm wondering like why these comedians
can't
get along.
I did that on purpose. Like I auditioned for Apollo on purpose.
Okay.
I wanted to challenge myself.
Okay.
I feel like enough artists don't challenge themselves. We can sing, so we do weddings, we do this and that. We funny, we do this and that. But sometimes you gotta put some heat on that ass. And that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to put some heat on. And I did.
Crazy.
I did. The heat was on.
You know, I remember I went to the Apollo a couple times, and I tried to boo some artists off there, and they were not having it. Even when
you wanted to boo her?
No, I'm not. I only boo if I really feel like the person should not be up there with the rest of the competition.
Right.
And you know, like, once one person starts to boo, it's almost like a chain reaction. Everybody's booing.
And that's what happened to me. This one guy said boo, and they think that they was like, boo! They think that the whole crowd was booing me. I was like, that hurt my heart.
So would you ever go back, or you like, nah, I'm done?
Well, actually, I got booked back to do Apollo December 5th.
Mm.
I'm at the Apollo on the book gig. Praise God. Want to do it.
There it is. There it is.
So sometimes you got to take that boo, that punch in the face, that punch in the stomach, that L for the team. But you keep pushing. You keep grinding. And it comes through.
There it is. That's what's up. Words of wisdom right there. All right, so I'm going to just ask one more question. If a movie was made about you, your entire life, from comedy, birth, school, everything, what celebrity would you want to play you?
Well, that's a good question.
I always throw like a wrench in there real quick. Just
that's
to make
a really
I want
good
like real answers, you know what I'm saying?
Tracy Morgan. Woo!
Why him? That's a good answer.
Everybody say I look like him.
I
want Tracy Morgan to play my biopic.
Tracy.
Well, I need to play his.
Either one. You know he the last OG. You might get you on, what is that, TBS?
You think I look like him?
No.
Everybody say I look like Tracy Morgan.
Is that your favorite comedian?
He's definitely one of my top five.
Who's like your number one? Like anything they do is
funny. I'm a Jamie Foxx fan because he sings, he plays the piano, and I'm an entertainer. My shows are never just about stand-up. I like entertainment. So I like to give a show. So whoever give a show is who I'm rocking with.
Yeah, we like Jamie. Jamie Foxx is the man. Word. All right, that's Monique Latise. I'm going to give you the floor. Anything you got you want to shout out, like your Instagram, anybody. Now's the time.
All right, thank you so much for this interview. You can catch me on the gram, Monique Latise, MoniqueLatise. You can inbox me, you know, ask me a question. I do a lot of relationship, you know, conversations. Inbox me, ask me something, I'll post it. Let's become friends.
There it is, you know what I mean? And you got, so December 4th, you said?
The 5th.
December 5th, the Apollo, you know what I'm saying? There it is. That's Face2Face. It's Abwon, Monique Latise. You already know what it is. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. We always got the hottest ones out here. We out.